Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the boxing quiz on BBTV, this lovely Sunday evening. Thank you again for joining us for this 1 hour of boxing trivia. Here are the rules. Grab a pen and paper, put Google away and test your knowledge. You may learn one or two things about boxing you never knew. So, no rabbit punches, no kidney punches. When I say break, you break clean. Are you ready to go to work? Let's get started with round one. The questions are being loaded. We are live. Stand by. Seconds out, round one. Question number one. Which current world champion goes by the nickname Hell Brooklyn? Is hit A. Shakur Stevenson? Is hit B. Devin Haney? Is hit C. Teofimo Lopez? Or is hit D. Joseph Diaz? Question 2. Which fighter has faced these three British boxers? Amir Khan, Sam Eggington and Ricky Hatton. Question 3. Do you recognize this voice?
Look, if it's got boxing gloves on and there's proper referees there, you know, nobody's going to get hurt, are they? You know, it's a fight. You know, if it is for a good cause, they'll make some money themselves. The NHS will make money. You know, it's not, personally, it's not for me. But the thing is, you know, they're in the 50s, they're keeping fit. They've got a goal to go at. You know, they're not like couch potatoes, sat down, overweight, cholesterol problems, whatever.
Question 4. Which boxer faced Jack Dempsey in the 1927 heavyweight title fight, known as the Battle of the Long Count? Was hit A. Gene Tunney, B. Jack Sharkey, C. Jess Willard, or was it D. Battling Levinsky? Question 5. Which current WBC world champion has an unbeaten record of 54 wins, no defeats, 18 wins coming by KO? Question number 6. Who was this former IBO world super featherweight champion?
Good guy that make money. You have the bad guys. If you're a bad guy and you can fight, you're going to make money. You're going to make a lot of money. But if you're a bad guy that talks trash and you can't back it up, boxing will forget you real quick. You know, because they're satisfied. Once you got your ass whooped, they're satisfied. They don't care. They don't care about you. You know what? All the talk that you do after that is meaningless because, you know, if you can't back up what you're putting out there, boxing, they'll forget you.
Question 7. Can you name the boxer in this photo? Question 8. Who was the first fighter to defeat Mike Tyson? Was it A. Evander Holyfield, B. Lennox Lewis, C. Danny Williams, or was it D. James Douglas? Question 9. Which former world heavyweight champion tragically died in a car crash, aged 69? And for the final question of round one, question 10, whose is this voice?
Pretty rough, but we fought three times. The first time he beat me up pretty bad, and I came back and I did my thing. And then the third fight was just one of those, I guess we were bored. we were past our prime, but I've gotten the chance to really know.
Well, that's the bell to end the first round. How do you think you did? Go grab a drink, check over your answers. We will be back for round two in just 1 minute. Henry Armstrong, born 1909, became the first boxer in history to hold world titles in three separate weight classes at the same time. His remarkable record was 152 wins, 22 defeats, 9 draws. 101 of his wins came by KO. After retiring from boxing, Armstrong became an ordained Baptist minister, working with disadvantaged youth. He also wrote the autobiographical book, God, Gloves, and Glory in 1956. He passed away in 1988 age 78, a true ring legend, and one of the very best of any era to grace a ring. We will be right back with round 2. seconds out, round two. Okay, let's go. Coach feels you need some motivation going into round two. Hopefully question one can give you some. Over to the TV. Can you name the boxer being motivated by Coach Teddy Atlas?
Now listen to me. You believe in magic. Magic. Sometimes we can bring people that left us back. We can bring your father back tonight. You know why? Because they're going to talk about his son, the new world champion. And when they talk about him, they're going to be thinking about his father.
Question 2. Why is the name Elvis Shane related to the Muhammad Ali versus Ernie Shaver's 1977 fight? Question 3. Who was the first boxer to win world titles at middleweight, light heavyweight and heavyweight? Question 4. Over to the TV. Who is this legendary fighter? And for one extra bonus point, which legendary fighter is he referring to?
For me to fight the prince after this fight, coming up the 17th, and the offer was made, and we want to fight. And since he wants to do a tour in America, you know, fight all the American fighters, I should be next, you know, to come down to America and fight me next. I think he's clowning around before he gets into the ring. He shouldn't be allowed to make a fight awake 10, 15 minutes in the ring and to do his little dance. He can lose a little dance after he beats the guy, you know, that's okay. Before the fight, there shouldn't be no dancing around for 15 minutes and walk into the ring. If I was Kelly, I would have ran there and grabbed him.
Question 5. Name the boxer. Whose are those eyes? Question 6. Fill in the blanks to reveal a boxer's name. Question 7. Where did the fight of the century take place? Ali versus Frazier won in 1971. Question 8. Welsh boxer Jimmy Wilde is boxing royalty, who fought from 1911 to 1923 and has the longest ever unbeaten winning streak. But do you know how many fights he went unbeaten for? Was hit A. 48-0, B. 49-0, C. 250-0, or was hit D. 104-0? Question 9. Who did Roberto Duran defeat on the 16th of June 1983 to win the WBA light middleweight title? And, for one bonus point, why else was the date even more significant for Duran? It is the final question of round 2. Question 10. Unscramble the letters to reveal a former world champion. First name and surname. The letters are F H I L L Y E N D E A V O R E D. I will repeat those letters again, so they are letters that reveal a former world champion. The letters are F H I L L Y E N D E A V O R E D. Good luck. How are you getting along? If you have got it already, you are amazing, and well on your way to winning this quiz and the fight. But, don't worry, if you haven't got it yet, we will have a 5-minute break, for you to have a think, before moving on to the answers from round 1 and 2, where you can see how you are doing, and compare your scores in the live chat. After that, we can get into the third and final round of the quiz, so I will see you back here in 5 minutes, fight fans. Welcome back. Okay, here are the answers for the first two rounds. Round 1. Answers to question 1 was Teofimo Lopez. Number 2, Paulie Malignaggi. 3, Peter Fury. 4, was Gene Tunney. 5, Chayefan Munsri. 6, Jeff Mayweather. 7, Michael Mura. 8, James Douglas. 9, Jack Johnson. And finally, the answer to question 10 of the first round was Sugar Ray Leonard. Onto the answers for round 2. And the answers to round 2. Number 1. The boxer was Alexander Povetkin. 2. Elva Shane was the first woman to judge heavyweight world title fight. 3. Bob Fitzsimmons. 4. Arturo Gatti was the legendary fighter, and Prince Nassim Hamid was the potential opponent he was speaking about. Number 5 was Joseph Parker. 6. Caleb Plant. 7. Madison Square Garden. 8. 104-0 was the unbeaten record of Jimmy Wilde. 9. The opponent was Davy Moore, and it was also Duran's birthday. And finally, the answer to the last question of round 2. Number 10. The word scramble. The boxer was Evander Holyfield. Okay, are all your scores in? How did you do? Leave your score in the comments. Third and final round coming up next. Seconds out. It is the third and final round of this quiz. Are you ready to finish this strong? Let's go. Round 3. Question 1. Who are the two boxers here fighting? You get 1 point for each boxer named. Thank you. Question 2. Who was the only British boxer to hold a world title at minimum weight, boxing's smallest weight class? Question 3. Which future world heavyweight champion did Tyson Fury's dad John Fury fight? Question 4. Which former world champion fought legendary fighters Floyd Mayweather, Julio Cesar Chavez, Pernell Whitaker, Manny Pacquiao, Arturo Gatti and Bernard Hopkins during the course of his career? Question 5. Which Russian heavyweight did David Haye defeat in 2009 to win the WBA world title? Question 6. Who is this two-weight world champion? Question 7. Which former world heavyweight champion was also a former world wrestling champion? Question 8. Which boxer was known as the Man of Steel, was hit? A. Rocky Graziano, B. Tony Zale, C. Max Baer, or was hit D. Jake LaMotta? Question 9. In 1985, which round did Marvin Hagler knock out Thomas Hearns in? And finally, question number 10 of round 3 and the final one of tonight's quiz. Who was this fight highlight video of? And for a bonus point, do you know his nickname? Well, there goes the bell to end the quiz. I do hope you have enjoyed it, and if you didn't know every question, at least you may have learned a thing or two about boxing that you didn't know before. Please stick around to hear the answers to round 3. Coming up next, tally up your scores, as this round could make all the difference. Okay, here we go. Here are the answers to the third and final round. Number 1. The fight on the TV was Freddie Roach against Greg Howgun. 2. Paul Weir. 3. Henry Akinwunde. 4. Oscar De La Hoya. 5. Nikolai Valuev. 6. Demetrius Andrade. 7. Primo Carnera. 8. Tony Zale. 9. Was round 3. And finally, question 10 of round 3 and the last question this evening, who was the highlight boxing reel of it, was the one and only, the late Pernell Whitaker. What a boxer, and his nickname was Sweet Pea. Well done if you got that. If you didn't and have never watched Pernell Whitaker in action, we suggest you do when you get the chance. So then, how did you do? Either way, I hope, even if you didn't know all of the answers, you at least learned a thing or two you didn't already know about the sweet science. Well, we hope you enjoyed today's quiz. We will stay online for 30 minutes if anyone wants to chat and compare scores, but do please join us again same time, 8 p.m. next Sunday for more boxing trivia. Stay safe out there. Until next time, good night, and hey you, keep punching.
Thank you.